Izzy, you guys have had a 2-0 start in the league, which is how you want to start in this league. How important are these next three games? Missouri at home, and then you got to go to Florida and then go to Auburn. How key is that for you guys to keep this momentum going?
I think it's very important for us, you know, to get these wins in the row because we've been, you know, playing at TBA so much, and we're not going to have that home atmosphere to keep on playing in. So I think once we get off, like, after Missouri and we go away for those two games, I think that it will really prove ourselves that we can really play in.
Player coming in from Missouri, I think she hit 11 threes the other night. Have you guys even talked about that yet? Have you had a chance to look at Missouri? Because that's going to be key, isn't it?
Definitely. We just, you know, been scouting them for these past two practices. So Dean already told us that that's a shooting team and we got to be ready to get in them and defend. So that's something we already know coming into these practices in the next game.
Talk about the overall success of this team so far this season. You guys were kind of looked at, I don't want to say as an underdog, but not the typical Tennessee women's team. And so far at this point, you guys have just done, kind of kept the train on the tracks.
I'm glad that, you know, we started off that way because it really gives us something to work on. And not having everybody on your side, it always gives you that more confidence and really nothing to lose. So the way we've been improving these practices and these games, it really just shows us what kind of team that we are, Tennessee team that we are.
Izzy, a lot of you players are playing more minutes now with the roster shrinks, at least for the time being. I mean, what do you have to be more mindful of, both on the court and off the court, under those circumstances?
We definitely need to be more mindful of how we are taking care of ourselves, definitely because, you know, the injuries and the amount of people that we have. And I just think that, you know, each player has to be more mindful of how many fouls they get in the game as well, especially me. I can't afford to be having those early fouls in the game because it really dictates us on the defensive end, and I just really don't want that for our team. So I think that when we put, you know, more energy and everything that we have to do, and just keep in mind that our roster is going to be this way for a little bit, and just once we get back into it, we'll be fine, but we just got to take care of what we got to do now.
How do you talk about being mindful of your fouls? I mean, how do you do that? Because you want to play aggressively and things like that, but you know, I mean, is that how do you do that? How do you try to be mindful, avoiding foul trouble and still playing the way you want to play?
Well, I feel like most of my fouls come from, I guess, from fatigue. And just, you know, trying to, like, I guess, slow the ball down. So I just really got to, you know, I feel like I'm pretty good shape now, but just really, you know, when it's getting hard, just don't try to bail them out with a foul. That's what Dean really talked to us about. So just, you know, staying in condition and just being disciplined on the defensive end, I can really help my team staying in the game.
Holly said at halftime on Sunday that she had to open up the bottle a little bit during halftime and kind of give you guys a little dose of Holly. What do you guys need to do, for especially in the last two games that you've seen, that you're not doing in the first half, that you're coming out in the second half with more energy? How do you get that going from the tip?
We definitely need to come out stronger on the defensive end, and that's just something that she's really been, you know, ranting us up at every halftime for these past two or three games. And we've really just got to come out stronger and just have every person leading, no matter if they're on the bench or on the floor, that defense is going to win this game. And if we come out with that type of energy and that mindset, then she won't be yelling us like that at halftime.
Talk about a dose of Holly. People across the SEC and across the nation, Coach Summit's leaving. People think that this program is down. Just talk about how she's been able to keep you guys where you are right now.
I mean, Holly, she's still, you know, our head coach at the same time, so she's going to be strict. So, I mean, bringing that meanness, that head coach's, I guess, role, I think she's really gotten into that, and she's really known that role. Okay, we can have fun in our times, but being strict, it really has, you know, its times, and I think she's really done a great job with that.
Is that something different than what she was doing before she was the HC?
Definitely, I think so. And now that she's doing it now, it's kind of weird, but at the same time, I'm just going to roll with it.
Rumor Johnson said that, you know, last year when Summit did step down, that Hollywood, people don't take her seriously. Was she like the friend last year at practice? Was she like the cool coach?
She was the cool coach, basically. At the same time, she was on us, but she was just more understanding, I guess, than like the head coach, I guess you would say. But she's gone to that role of, like, she has to be strict, and this is what she needs done. And, like, if she has to be mean and not your friend at times, she's going to do it. But she does it for a reason. It's not just because she's a head coach. She knows it's going to get this better. So
people have described you as a completely different player than last year. What happened over the offseason, and do you see – how much of a change do you see in your game from last year?
I definitely feel like my conditioning's gotten better. I feel like that my confidence has gotten a lot better. especially after the past players talking to me from last year coming to this year, they've seen that how much have I grown as a person on and off the court. And I just think that my maturity for this team has really stepped up. And I'm just glad, like, I can be in that role to do it for them, because even Dean told me last year there's going to come a time and a place, and now it's my time, and I just got to step up to the plate.
Was the problem maybe at first, because I know last year you're used to playing. You're used to playing when you were in high school, but you were behind All-Americans. And so I think Holly said that you couldn't really stomach that. Like, you wanted to be on the court.
Yeah, it was just hard for me to understand, like, not being on a team that I really wasn't needed that much. But I'm glad. It's a blessing, honestly. If I really didn't go through what I did through last year, I don't think I would be the person I am today for this team. And to make it better for what it is right now, I really had to humble myself and understand that those players were there to help me, and even the coaching staff, no matter what was going on. So I'm just glad that happened to us.
What are some of the things the former players told you recently, or maybe that they told you last year in terms of getting you ready to play at the level you were in?
Basically, you know, not to get my self-esteem down from not playing. And they saw so much potential in me that I didn't really see in myself last year. And now that I actually see it coming out, like, it all started making sense. You know, Gore, Vicky, Strick, Free, A-Town, all the seniors that they left, they really just told me, like, keep my head up. Like, next year I'm going to have to lead this team and be an example. And I have to lead from the post, and I'm not going to have chances to be on the bench all game like I had last year. So really just being grateful for that and coming out to play every game, and it just showed me that I'm getting better.
Talk about go ahead.
You talked about improving your conditioning during the offseason. What was your regimen like? What were you doing during the offseason to get you ready to –
Well, usually, last year I was here for summer school, so I was with Heather, so I had a whole summer to myself, basically, to just do what I knew I needed to work on. So I was just at home every day. I went running with my little brother in the mornings, and then even twice a day. Then we would go down to the center from our house, and we would play basketball with, like, some of the college players from, like, TSU, ETSU, all the players, like, colleges in Nashville. So we would just all go to the center and play. And it was against boys. I like going against them, so I really learned a lot and got my conditioning really up, so it helped a lot.
Talk about Missouri a little bit. What you know about them?
They're definitely a shooter team, and I think that we haven't really, I guess, played against teams like that has been such a great shooting team. So I think that it's really going to be a challenge for us to really defend and, like, not rely so much on stopping. We have to defend outside the paint. And that's what we've been so great at doing. So I think it's going to be a great challenge for us.
Well, every time you play a team that, you know, can shoot the three, it's either the first half or just throughout the game. Holly's so upset how many threes they, you know, drain. Why has that been? You guys know the game plan, but why has it been, you know, stopping the three-point shot? Like, kind of been you guys' issue, I guess, when you play a shooting team?
I just feel like, you know, teams do have great three-point shooters, but it really shows when they play us. You know, just being in front of our crowd and, like, who we are, it just gets their confidence and their everything up when they play us. So I feel like they're feeling themselves during that game. But I just think we got to keep on bringing ourselves out and defend and stick to Holly's game plan, and it shouldn't be a problem.
Big picture, what do you think the end result of this team is, big picture kind of going forward?
Big picture for this team. I definitely see us going far, far in the tournament, even continuing past that just because of our defense, you know. If to me, especially from the comments of the team, they said our defense has gone tremendously. Like, it's grown so much. So from us, from coming from here and continuing down the road, it's only going to get better. So, and that's what's going to win games. And I feel like we have that confidence, even on the defensive end. It's going to, you know, show on the offensive end. So I think that I really see us going real far.